Hey guys, what's up? I'm Nicole, and today we are here to talk about keto candy. Now, if you're like me, you've probably heard about this thing called the keto diet. And if you're also like me, you're probably thinking, huh? Keto? What is that? That sounds made up. To give you a little bit more insight on the keto diet and why we're eating almond butter cups, because I mean, yeah, those sound weird. That's not normal. Keto diets are most commonly a high fat, low carb, medium amount of protein diet. Keto candy, it's keto certified, so that means follows all the keto diet guidelines. There's 6 grams of fat in one of these, which to some people you're like, oh, 6 grams of fat. Newsflash, don't ever look at the nutrition facts of regular candy. If you go and look at the nutrition facts of almost any type of normal candy, you will probably just want to put that candy down and run away. I don't know if you're aware of this or not, but most candy, it's not actually good for you.
I'll just enjoy this glass of water. I'm stuffed.
But you know what? We've only got one life to live, so we might as well enjoy it with candy. And some people that are on their keto diets, they also still want to enjoy their lives, so they eat keto candy, like these almond butter cups that I have in my hand. Since I am not on a keto diet because I eat way too much candy, I thought, well, let's give these a shot and let's do a taste test and see if these compare to any sort of normal candy, like my favorite, Reese's peanut butter cups. Now we went with the Reese's Thins because, well, it's more comparable. There's only 10 grams of fat in 3 of these, so right there, that seems okay. We'll not talk about the total amount of sugar or carbs or anything else in here. Let's just focus on the fact that there's only 4 more grams of fat than there is in these. Let's just rip into them and find out if they even taste good, because that's what it really comes down to. If they don't taste good, I'm not gonna keep eating them. These little guys, they're all individually wrapped. How cute is that? It's to probably help with portion control, so you're not like, oh, the whole bag was open. I had to just keep eating them. They want you to stick to your diet. So these are dark chocolate almond butter cups. I like almonds. I feel like this could be good. I like dark chocolate. It's made with some organic stuff, yada yada. It smells kind of like peanut butter, except not peanut butter. It's almond butter. It looks like a normal peanut butter cup. Smells like chocolate. It's so tasty too. Tastes just like candy. It's got that bitter dark chocolate taste, which I don't usually mind. I guess because of the lack of sugar in the almond butter, it's not really balancing out the way that I would like for it to. It's not bad. The almond butter center, it's quite tasty, but I can see why they package these individually, because once you eat one, you're probably not gonna wanna rip open anymore. If it were the only candy that I could eat, I would still eat it. I'm definitely not gonna wanna rip open any more of those tonight. It's lacking something, and I guess that's sugar. I don't know. There's 5 grams of sugar in one, but I assume it's just because it's organic sugars, not the quality sugar that I have been raised to enjoy my entire life. Not bad, but now I'm going to joyfully wash that down with one of these. And look, you're so cute, Reese's, trying to stop me with just one. You're wrapping. It won't stop me at all. While I usually do not opt for the thin Reese's, because that just makes me want to eat like 3 more of them, it is the closest thing to those almond butter cups. They were about the exact same size. They look the same. These are made with milk chocolate. The others were dark, so there's that. The others, they did a pretty good job. They could pass them off as Reese's, like dark chocolate Reese's. If you had them on a tray, you could serve them at a party and be like, yeah, they're totally dark chocolate. And people wouldn't know until they ate them. That's where it's at. They've always been one of my favorite candies. How long have they been around? Years. Hundreds of years, I'm sure. Maybe not. Hershey Company hasn't been around that long. They've been around as long as I've been alive, so they're doing something right. This keto stuff, they've still got time, okay, to perfect the taste of their candy. But if I were at the grocery store and I had to choose, just based on the nutrition facts alone, serving size of these is 3. a serving size of these is one.
A third of a gopher would only arouse my appetite without bedding her back down.
I'm gonna go with these because, according to the nutrition facts, I can eat more in one sitting and not have to feel bad about it.
Oh, you can have the whole thing.
So isn't that really what life is all about? And you know what else? If you subscribe to our channel, that's gonna bring so much joy into your life, just like all of these Reese's bring into my life.
I don't care if you do have 10 grams of fat. I still love you, Reese's.
Maybe you know someone who is on a keto diet and they've been dying to find some keto candy. You can share this video with them and say, hey, this crazy person tried this candy and she said it was not bad, so you should also try it. I'm gonna hold off on eating any more of these. Against my better judgment, I would like to have this whole bag, but serving size, it said I can only eat three, so I'll put these in my pocket for later. It's a serving, so I don't want to cheat myself. If you know of any other keto candies that are very similar to a mainstream candy, let us know in the comments. We'll find it, we'll try it, we'll give it a taste test, and I'll let you know what I think about it. 100%. It says a weird word on the side that I'm not even gonna try to pronounce. The other side says organic. I can't pronounce that for the internet, but good old Reese's, they don't put any words on there that I can't read. That's it, guys. Now you know. Keto candy, it's okay. If that's all you can have, go for it. It won't be the worst thing you've had in your life.